If a picture is worth a thousand words, then scent is definitely priceless. I'm Miguel Sagaz, and join me today as we go behind the notes of Le Labo.
You would ask me which one of your kids you prefer.
That's true.
Even though I prefer one of the two. The chair you're sitting in has a huge story too.
What is it? I want to know the story now. What am I sitting on? Esta mañana tengo el placer de platicar con uno de los co-creadores de la compañía Le Labo. Él es Fabrice Benoit. Good morning, Fabrice. Thank you so much for joining me.
Good morning, Miguel.
And welcoming me into this space, which is the first Le Labo store, right?
Absolutely. This was built 8 years ago now as the first attempt for us to share the backstage of perfume creation with New Yorkers.
Walk me through the process of creating Le Labo. Like, how was the idea born?
Really, behind Le Labo was a first-hand encounter between Edouard and I. He's my business partner and friend, and has been obviously a big part of this adventure. We met at Giorgio Armani when we were creating fragrances for the master when we were young, and very quickly we decided to try to reinvent a new way of telling stories in perfumery.
So would you say there's a story behind every scent here at Le Labo?
There is a story behind everything we do, even beyond the scents themselves. The chair you're sitting in has a huge story too.
What is it? I want to know the story now. What am I sitting on?
Well, for example, this chair.
Like, what happened in this chair?
This chair. Back in the days when we built that first store, we couldn't afford vintage furniture. Mm-hmm. So this chair was actually looking brand new at the time, almost brand new. It was very cheap, and we destroyed it with a cheese grater.
Okay.
And a sandpaper, and we gave it the patina that the time didn't have the time to get it yet.
Here in Le Labo, you have something that's really frustrating for a lot of us and really amazing at the same time, which is the city exclusives. Where did the idea came from? Was it just to tease people to make it more exclusive, to want to go and travel the world and get your scent? What is it?
We don't try to sound exclusive or to be or to tease people. I mean, it's true that we like to play with people.
Yes.
Like the same way that we play with ourselves.
Which is highly successful, yeah. Let me tell you. I agree and I love that about the company. But
saying by play with ourselves, I want to make sure I didn't say something that sounds weird in English.
But
it's something almost personal. You know, when we opened our first store, the second store in Tokyo, mm-hmm. and then in LA, and then we were like, and we felt so honored, like we were young business owners, like we felt so honored to be welcomed by these people in Japan first, and essentially, like wow, and we like connecting with people we didn't know, with cultures we didn't know, and we wanted to honor this gift of being there, mm-hmm. and by creating this perfume was kind of these perfumes then was kind of a way for us to pay tribute to these locations that we were going to.
Now, if you could design a scent for anybody, dead or alive, who would you want to create a scent for, and what would that smell like?
Would you mind if I extend myself to history? And
No.
You wouldn't mind, or you don't let me do it?
I don't mind. I thought you were going to say Miguel Sagaz, but I guess it's too soon.
I would be too afraid that you would take me up to my word. Now, there is a few people, like, I don't know, like, for example, Einstein, maybe. I absolutely adore this guy. I had door is the way he broke all the rules and he looked at science in a very different way. He was most likely one of the most important men of the last century. You know, this very famous quote that says, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. And this has been tremendously impacting my personal and work life. Something like very white, very light, very musky, with a touch of craziness, something that makes the thing go wild, like a spice, or something that twists the whole thing and make it look like his haircut.
Nice, I like that. And now going into your life, what is your personal scent? Do you change or do you have like a signature scent that you go to?
It's a tough one because I have kids.
Yeah.
I have kids and I really feel like all these perfumes are... It's hard to... like you would ask me which one of your kids you prefer.
That's true.
Even though I prefer one of the two. I would not be able to say the same thing with my perfumes. But
it's a sex tape, we won't show it to your children.
No, it's not true. What's true is that for a few years now I've been only wearing Santa Felipe. Every morning, I'm not lying, every morning I wake up and the most exciting part for me about these days to start it, going under the shower and shower with the Santa Felipe shower gel.
Now tell me, just wrapping it up, about the process of creation, because it's not only, you know, born in grass, raised in New York, as it says, about the quality of products, about the process of bringing the products, and also the packaging, which is so beautiful and so minimal, and yet I feel like there's a lot of thought behind it. Walk me through that.
So the creation process, as a start, everything we do is inspired by this Japanese philosophy of wabi-sabi.
Right.
Wabi-sabi is an aesthetical philosophy, like almost a vision, a way to see life that celebrates the awareness of the impermanence of things. Not only in the creation of perfumes, but of packaging, in the way we deal with people. We celebrate imperfection, we celebrate our own cracks. Because I don't remember who said that, but that's how the light gets in. The cracks.
Last question. If you could go back in time and give younger Fabrice some advice, what would you tell him?
Wow. First, I hate giving advices, even to myself as a young man, and I hate receiving them as well.
Interesting.
I hate to lead and I hate to follow. So it's actually an issue as an entrepreneur. When not like I would say, don't water down your dreams. Don't listen to the rational and reasonable people who tell you all these things are not possible. I would tell him, make sure that if you have to partner with someone, partner like you have to think it over 100 times to make sure that this is for the long run. It's as important, if not more, that than the choice of your life partner.
Mexico City, plans to go to Mexico City?
Mexico, we would love to.
You guys need to tell me when you get it so we can...
Frankly, it's a low-hanging fruit for us. We have a lot of fans in Mexico. Lots of very sensitive people there. Mexico City and San Paulo will be next two stops. You might guide us.
I would love to. I would really love to. I think we can...
And frankly, it's a question of encounters. Yeah. So maybe today is a nudge for us to go to the next step. But we love Mexico City, and We'll see you soon, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much.